With the prerequisite of configuring Pangolin Beyond and patching it into the MagicQ console, we're now ready to go ahead and create our Punt page. Now, we've already got several lighting faders set up ready to go for our show, so we're going to be adding in lasers as special effects and accents. Now, the first thing I need to do is create an intensity fader. This way, I can fade in and fade out laser cues. Next, I need to create playbacks for the four additional channels that we have created. Then I want to add in the actual laser cues themselves. We're going to add in a cone, a fan, a wave, and a beam field. We also want to create an executor button for blacking out the lasers. And then finally, I want to go ahead and add in a beam sequence fader as well. Since I'd already configured a lighting punt page, I want to go ahead and rename some of these cues so that they make a little bit more sense for me later on. That way I don't mix up my lighting cues and my laser cues. With my corrections made, now I'm ready to go ahead and set up my intensity fader. So if I adjust the intensity channel, it'll be the only channel inside of the programmer that's been modified. Now I'm ready to record this to my fader. So what I'm going to do is click on the record button and go ahead and select fader 5. Now I'm going to go ahead and give this a much more meaningful name. So I'll go ahead and click on my set button and then go ahead and label this as intensity lasers. With the Pangolin group palette item selected, I'm going to come over to my beam palette on page 5 and go ahead and change the value on the encoder for my tap sync. I will then go ahead and click on the record button and put this into playback number 10. I will then go ahead and repeat the steps for my resync button and record that into playback 9. With the two playbacks recorded, I will now set the labels on playback 9 to resync and playback 10 to tap sync. One very important note is that if ChamSys is not configured to reset unused channels to default, then you would need to manually set these playbacks to use LTP. The last step here will be to configure the laser intensity effects. We'll be using the color effects in the next tutorial. We're now ready to configure the cues on our lighting board. Now I have 5 different types of effects that I'd like to use here. I'd like to use some sweeping cones, some fans or sheets, some waves, some beam fans, and then finally a beam chase or beam sequence. I want to configure all of these cues to work from my extra wing. If I go to the playback screen in MagicQ, I can see that I've already got several entries, such as position cues, color cues, and special effects such as a strobe. What I'm going to do is configure on playbacks 18 through 22 several different laser cues. The first thing I will do is go ahead and slide up my laser intensity fader so that I can see any cues that I activate. The next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and select Pangolin Beyond for my group palette. And with Pangolin Beyond selected, I'm then going to go over to my beam palette by clicking on the beam button and then using the page and cue encoders to find the cue I'm looking for. In this case, I'm looking for a very nice cone effect. I can see what this looks like in my visualizer as I'm sliding the encoders. This way I can find a really eye-catching, sweeping cone effect. Once I find a cone effect that I like, I can go into the programming page in MagicQ and verify that these are the changes that I want to add into my playback. So what I'm going to do is click on the record button and specify for playback 18 that I want to set this particular cue. I'm then going to click on the set button, click on playback 18, and name this cones. I will do the same thing for all of the other effects that I want to add into MagicQ. Now, if I've got a playback for all my different cues, I need a way to stop these cues. So we need a blackout cue. So in order to go ahead and configure this, I'm going to go ahead and select Pangolin Beyond for my group playback, click on my beam button to open up my beam palette, and then open up the encoder page that has my page and cue options and set both page and cue to 0. Now with my programmer populated with the values that I want to change, I'm going to go ahead and assign them to the appropriate playback on my playback wing. Now the last cue I want to go ahead and add to my board is the beam sequence. Beam sequences are great when there is very fast drum beats or guitar solos. Now I've got two extra playbacks that I can use. Now I will go ahead and select Pangolin Beyond from my group palette, go to my beam palette, and then again set the appropriate page and cue. Now I have this on a custom page and a custom cue for my beam sequence. So I want to be sure that I am, as I'm going through each one of these cues, finding the correct cue to use. Once I have that cue set, I will go ahead and again validate it in my playback, go to my playback page, click record, and assign it to the playback cue that I want. Once completed, I'll go ahead and click on set, give it the name of beam sequence, or in this case I'm going to call it beam show, and then clear my programmer. Now that I've assigned several cues to several different playbacks, I can go ahead and start activating those playbacks with my intensity fader all the way up and my enable laser button active. This way I can kind of see what these cues will look like with different lighting cues.